today, Wild Bill's, I work at. And there they continue to employ people with disabilities and have volunteers that are students and job coaches. And it's extended to Uptown Bills, which is referred to as the Bigger Batter Bills. Uptown Bills has existed for around 15 years now. So that's pretty exciting. So we have a couple different things going on tonight. I think it's mostly music tonight. We have four or five performers. Tomorrow night we also have a live musical performance at 7 p.m. As well as Saturday night, we have a guest, Scott Ingledow, who plays a pretty unique style of guitar, a blend of pop and other music. That's at 7 p.m. as well. Here at Uptown Bills, we do a lot of different stuff. We do a lot of community groups. We do our music nights. We also help a lot of other individuals with disabilities start their own businesses. We've had a vintage shop, we've had furniture refurbishing shop, record store, a lot of different businesses. Our newest project is a radio station, which you might, if you've been here the past nights, you might be missing. We usually have a banner up behind us. It's called KICI 105.3 FM. We're hoping to have it on air pretty soon. Trying to figure out exactly where to put it. We was going to put it on Old Brick, but we'll see if that happens. So Uptown Bills Live started as a Thursday night gathering for songwriters, it evolved, you know, went back and forth from Friday nights to Thursday nights, evolved as we've changed different locations, but we're back to Thursday nights now for a little while now, so everyone that tunes in regularly every Thursday night, thank you very much. That's probably enough for me for tonight. I think first up is Tim with the trumpet, if you're ready and like to come up.
Year-old trumpet I've had laying around for a while. It's a long story behind it, but I was in the sixth grade when they made this. We got back together a few years later. I won't tell the long story. I will explain what I'm trying to do. I take trumpet lessons, so don't give up. Don't leave yet, because this doesn't take long. We want the folks at home to... Oh, I see. I wasn't talking to the microphone, but I'm not going to start over. No, I don't want to tell them much more than I already told them. The main thing is I take trumpet lessons every week and I practice every day. So far, it got me here. Just a few exploratory notes. Oops, my practice mute. Listen. Yeah, thank you, Lord. What a relief. I have a jive hive in my basement, but there's no insulation down there, so Mrs. hears everything down there. So I have a quieter, downer thing. All right. First song I'm going to play is named Cute. It's an old-timey jazz standard, and it's all about how, do you mind if I say you're cute, but they don't do that anymore, you get a fist. So we just play the song. There's a whole band in my head.
Thank you. Real important. You got to hold your mouth right. You don't always know what's going to come out of the horns. A lot of times I stop. But I did practice that song this morning, but it didn't sound any better. And then this one is a song that has a huge bunch going on in my head that you guys can't hear. I'm sorry, but none of y'all were alive anyway when this was on the radio in the early 60s. But it's named Little Darlin', and it was a big hit in a weird situation among Beatles and Bob Dylan and Beach Boys, for God's sakes. And then, Count Basie and his orchestra. It used to be AM radio, had all that shit at the same time and sang out. Are you with me so far? That's Little Darlin'. Thank you. Thanks a lot. That helps a lot. The hardest thing about playing a horn is that you've got to relax totally, and you can't have a lot of tension going on from here up, and it gets all tense in here, and as you hear, a lot of stuff comes out. I guess it gets better the more better you get relaxed. Okay, never mind. We'll see how it goes. This is named Like Someone in Love. And it's a partly James Van Heusen song. And it's kind of cute. It's a little modern, but it was written like Truman times or Eisenhower a long time ago. But I think it sounds pretty modern. See there? You never know what's coming out until you hear it. Relax. Thank you. That's like someone in love. So, got time for one more? Is that it? Those are pretty quick little songs. I've got bongos with me. If anybody wants bongo accompaniment, I can handle it. Let's see. Goodbye. Cry. Should we cry me a river or goodbye, pork pie hat? Any requests? I'm going to play something anyway. It's blues. I'm going to play a blues song. This here is a blues song. It's named Goodbye, Pork Pie Hat. It's a funeral dirge, so it's really a reason to be blue. Thank you. That was written for a funeral for the guy that wore the pork pie hat. Thank you. It's Beat Prairie, and I'll be on standby listening in case somebody wants bongo drum accompaniment.
The drum set you have too. Thank you very much. Brave of you to. So you and the trumpet have been together since sixth grade, but separated for a while. Okay. Oh. Okay. Well, we're glad you're. Bringing it here, so hope to see you again at birth. Okay, a couple things I was thinking about. Well, Terry's coming up next, but he looks like he's thinking about something. So while he's thinking, I will. Today is, of course, Groundhog Day, but you may not know that it is also Hedgehog Day. If you'd like an alternative in the rodent category. Or it's also Tater Tot Day. So, yeah, that's probably why. So, although I was saying just before we began tonight that I'm not so sure about the groundhog here. I'd much rather put my trust in a prairie dog or a gopher as to what kind of weather we're going to have. So. It seems to me that this Punxsutawney Phil does fine where he lives, but not so good for us. So one other thought before Terry comes up. Valentine's Day is coming up, and you remember the Cupid character? So I've been working on a modern Cupid. He or she would use a laser pointer instead of that bow and arrow, you know. and probably drive a PT Cruiser around, and would sit like in a, you know, you could see them in Cupid in the bar, you know, kind of going, kind of get people to together, something like that. Anyway, I'm just beginning, but if you'd like to add to that, you know, please talk to me. Maybe there's a, as I'm a number of years in the newspapers, and I would say, could be a column there. All right, I think Terry's ready. He is standing, and he's coming up on stage, and what's he got? He's got an extra set of things tonight. Are we looping? Is that what we got?
Yes.
Ooh.
Looping? No. It's going to add a little bit of an effect.
An effect?
Yes.
Okay.
And it'll go along with your Cupid. I thought maybe lawn darts instead of like the bow and arrow. Lawn darts to, for love?
Well,
I don't know.
They could do damage. If you lawn
damage.
Darts.
Oh, yes.
That's right.
Right.
Unless okay. You had the suction cup ones.
Suction cup. Yeah. Right on the forehead.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to play.
All right. Hold on, folks at home. We have a little bit of electronic business to do here. And let's see. Hold on, folks in the audience, too, of course. But, you know, you could turn around and pick out a book or something. Maybe the folks at home, this is a time to go to the fridge, find that perfect treat. Did anybody smell something kind of a little bit odd when you came in tonight, like there had been a fire or something burning? Well, I cooked a tamale, and I found that you can light the corn husk on fire in the microwave. I did it tonight. I never realized that was possible. Pardon? In the microwave, yeah. A little fire in there. So.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Fire.
But I didn't know you could do that with a tamale. We have a really powerful microwave. Abby, it's the one right around the corner there. And, you know, I mean, whoa. So I learned tonight, you can light a tamale on fire. All right, are you ready?
I've been sitting down over here, actually.
You are?
Yes.
What
unusual.
About that stool?
I know. Tim, you use the stool. This is a sign and sit. So after the show, you got to sign it.
All right. Our performers tonight are not using the microphone. We're sorry, people at home. They keep wandering off around the stage somewhere. We don't have the ones up above, you know, like they do in the big TV stations. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Yeah. There we go. Yep. I like it. Is everybody in? We always need more bass. That's in my contract. That sounds pretty good. How's everybody doing tonight? I'm Terry, and this is my ghost band. They're still warming up. Ghost Band and I, we're going to be doing a concert in E minor tonight. Thank you.
I am time. But there's no waiting. Wait for me, and your time is fleeting. I am leisure. There's the ages within me. I am to be living, or had existed. Thank you. That was the Ghost Band Jam. They're a bunch of good guys. Hey, don't judge them just on their appearance alone. They're actually good musicians. I never know who's going to be appearing night from night to night. The other day, I thought I saw Keith Moon in the audience, and I thought, man, I'm going to be playing with Keith Moon up here on stage. I realized then that the afterlife has not been good to Keith Moon. He looked happy, though. Bring me your gift. What surprise you gonna hit me with? I am waiting here for more. I am waiting by your door. I am waiting on your back steps. I am waiting in my car. I am waiting by this bar. I am waiting for your essence. Whisper my name, shoot your love into my veins, baby, sweet baby, kiss me hard. Make me wonder who's in charge. I am waiting here for more. I am waiting by your door. I am waiting on your back step. I am waiting in my car. I am waiting by this bar. I am waiting for your essence. I want to feel your breath. Even though you like to flirt with death, baby, sweet baby, can't get enough. Come on, find me and help me get fucked up. I am waiting here for more. I am waiting by your door. I am waiting on your back steps. I am waiting in my car. I am waiting by this bar. I am waiting for your essence, your essence, your essence. Thank you. That was Essence by Lucinda Williams. I did it last week, but I did it so horribly, I had to play it again this week. Redeem myself. I was talking to my kid brother in California last night, and I told him I'd say hi to him, mention his name. Corey, if you're watching, I'm watching you. All right. Riders on the storm, riders on the storm, into this house we're born, into this world we're thrown. Like a dog without a bone, an actor out alone, riders on the storm. There's a killer on the road, his brain is squirming like a toad. Take a long holiday, let your children play, if you give this man a, if you give this man a ride, sweet Emily will die, killer on the road. Girl, you've gotta love your man. Girl, you've gotta love your man. Take him by the hand. make him understand. The world on you depends, on our life will never end. Gotta love your man. Riders on a storm. Riders on a storm. Into this house we're born. Into this world we're thrown. Like a dog without a bone, an actor out on loan. Riders on a storm. That's it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm Terry, and this was the Ghost Band.
Thank you so much. Nora's next, but before she comes up, let's have the drawing for tonight. Mark's got the basket, and we'll come up and we'll draw a couple winners. We're giving away a copy of the documentary film about Bill tonight, A Friend Indeed, it's called. So let's see. You want to pick one? Here we go. Suspense must be present to win. Judy. There you are. Yes. Well, let's give her the other prize then, which is the Mark Twain story. That's from an evening here a few months ago. And songs and stories about Mark Twain. Samuel Clemens. Wow. Okay, and to win, Michael. Not, that's gone. Ah, Mr. Prairie. Okay. Thank you. And now we'll have Nora come up, and she's got her ukulele with her, and we'll see. She's been on this stage before, but it was for a totally different event in the fall. And I guess twice, actually, right? Yeah. Oh, me? I get to hear the thing? Okay, all right. Sounds good. Do you want to stand or sit or?
I'll sit there.
Okay. And do we, let's see, we probably should get a little mic for the uke, too, because you don't plug in, right? Okay. Well, let's pull this over to the center a little bit.
Chair to the center
so you can be seen by the audience at home. Down, and then we'll adjust microphones accordingly to suit you and your instrument. This one we know works. It's been used by a number of different people.
Yeah, So this is my first time at Uptown Bills Live, and I feel very welcomed here, so thank you. Yeah. I don't feel like if I mess up that you guys are going to throw things at me or anything like that, so I appreciate that. Okay. All right. Which is called Wagon Wheel, and it was written by Bob Dylan, and it was made popular by Old Crow Medicine Show. And then the next one that I wanted to do was called Ho Hey, and it's by the Lumineers. Is the sound still okay? Okay, all right. Okay. I've been sleeping in my bed. Nice, thank you. Okay, can I do one more? Okay, so this one is by Ellie King. It's called X's and O's.
I'm going to come up and ask you a couple questions.
Okay.
So you can sit back down if you want. Terrific. I'm so glad you finally made it here.
Yeah, thank you.
To Uptown Bills. I wanted to say that another person who was here a few weeks ago, Jenshin Miller, was at the Mill this week for the open mic on Monday night. So pretty exciting. And I recommend that to you, too.
Thank you.
Jay Knight organizes that, and you have to call him, which is always the big thing, like, what is he going to bite me through the phone or something like that? But he's a really nice guy, and he happened to be here when Jenshin was here for a concert, so I just introduced them to each other, and then poof, he's up there. So hope you'll think about that, too. When did you start playing?
I started playing the ukulele, I think, in the fall. It's not a difficult instrument to learn, so I was playing full songs, you know, in a couple of days, and I'm not a person who can naturally do stuff like that, so I recommend it, and I started really working on my singing about a year ago, but I've always enjoyed singing a lot, so.
Do you play other instruments, too?
And I play the piano a little bit, and so I took lessons in high school for a little while and then stopped for a long time and then have resumed playing piano just in the last year or so.
Ah, okay, so not as long as Bee Prairie and the trumpet.
No.
Not quite as many years before you got reunited.
No.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hope you'll be back again.
Sure, thank
and
you.
And keep in mind the Mill, too.
Okay.
All right. There were the two big open mics. We're catching up to them. will be 15 years old next month. Of course, they're 32. 32 years that Jay has been doing this. So let's see. Abby went around and asked the question for tonight, which was, would you rather, well, I'll let her do it. Come on up.
All right, so the question of the night was, would you rather live 500 years in the past or 500 years in the future, and why? So this person said, in the past, willing to relive versus be jolted down into space without green Mother Nature. Oh, jolted into space. That's valid. This person said, I don't know, and then crossed it out and wrote past and circled it. Because the honey was sweeter. This person said, future! Exclamation point. Because I already know what the past looks like. That's a good thought. 500 years in the future. Because I will be in heaven, and I don't believe the world will still exist. 500 years in the future. Are we going to be around? That's the real question. That is, I should have clarified. And another for the future. That's all our answers for tonight. Thank you all for contributing.
Thank you so much. We do that almost every week, and we haven't figured out a way that we can involve you folks at home. I guess if we asked the question earlier, we could post it on Facebook or some other social media, put it on Twitter or something, so that you could answer it there, and then we could read those answers. We have tried, sometimes afterwards, we'll post the answers on the Uptown Bills Facebook page, and then invite people to add their own responses too. And we've gotten some comments that way. So thanks to Abby and to Mark for helping us out tonight. It's very nice. Emily, who's usually here, is doing something for class, she said. I think we'll believe her this time. But who knows whether we'll believe her in the future. We'll see if this gets to be a pattern. Also going on here tonight, there's an essential oils class in the other room. So when we're done, if you want to wander in there, or if you're watching us and you want to wander down, interesting stuff. So great smells. And when they're done, the place really smells good. All right, I'm going to close. I have a little, been thinking about immigration and refugees a lot, and I write a newsletter for Uptown Bills every week, and this week I took the time to write a little bit about immigration. As you know, our founder was the, Bill Sachter, was the son of two immigrants from Russia. Most of us in the United States are the children, grandchildren, or great-grandchildren of immigrants. We are the descendants of people who came here seeking a better life. So we're predisposed to accept new people into this country, especially those fleeing political oppression and religious persecution. But from time to time, we drift away from this ideal and have to be reminded of our commitment to new generations of immigrants. This last week has been a jolting reminder of that commitment and how easily it can be undone. Bill Sachter's parents came to the U.S. from Russia in the early 1900s to escape religious persecution. They were part of a wave of 2 million Jews who left Russia between 1880 and 1920. Most of them came to the United States. Sam, Bill's dad, and Mary, Bill's mom, Sachter, settled in Minneapolis and opened a grocery store, but it was not an easy life. First, of course, there was just the basic struggle of settling into a new country, but there was also strong religious prejudice against the Jewish immigrants from Russia and from Eastern Europe. Little did they know that Minneapolis at that time was well on its way to becoming the most anti-Semitic city in the country. Then in 1905, the U.S. banned anarchists, it quotes, a broad term aimed particularly at those with radical political views who had emigrated from Eastern Europe and Russia. A subsequent law in 1918 significantly broadened the ban to include anti-war protesters and members of certain labor unions. Using that law, the U.S. government not only blocked some immigrants from coming, but also rounded up thousands of legal immigrants for deportation. An emergency committee to impose the deportation was formed in response. That led to the formation of the American Civil Liberties Union by a host of well-known people, including Jane Addams, one of Social Work's founding mothers. Here's that story. Jane Addams had a vision of free people living in a free country. Again and again, she spoke and wrote about the importance of freedom and democracy. To advance this idea, she also played a key role in the formation of a host of organizations, including the NAACP, the National Women's Suffrage Association, and the Women's International League for Peace and Freedom. Events in 1919 and 1920 prompted her to join others in forming still another group, the American Civil Liberties Union. In November 1919, federal agents all over the U.S. arrested about 10,000 people. Those detained were targeted solely because of their political views. Most were never charged with any crime. Most were held in jail for a long time. About 250 of those were formally arrested, including Emma Goldman, who was later deported. Addams spoke against this injustice in a November 1919 speech in Chicago. She said, "Hundreds of poor laboring men and women are being thrown into jail and police stations because of their political beliefs. In fact, an attempt is being made to deport an entire political party. These men and women, who in some respects are more American in ideals than the agents of the government who are tracking them down, are thrust into cells so crowded they can't lie down. And what is it these people seek? It's the right of free speech and free thought, nothing more than is guaranteed to them under the Constitution of the United States. We are trying to suppress something on which this country is based, liberty." But the protests of Addams and others were ignored by the U.S. Attorney General, Mitchell Palmer, and a young J. Edgar Hoover, his special assistant and later head of the FBI. In January 1920, these two federal officials ordered the arrest of another 6,000 people. Again, few were charged with any crime, and many were held for months in jail. That prompted Addams and other activists to call a meeting. Must have been some evening when they got together. John Dewey was there, a leading voice for progressive education. Upton Sinclair was there, the author and journalist and the author of the book The Jungle about meatpacking. Elizabeth Gurley Flynn was there, a labor organizer. Her autobiography, Rebel Girl, takes its title from a song written for her by Joe Hill. Others there included Helen Keller, Jeanette Rankin, the first woman in Congress and a social worker, and James Weldon Johnson, a poet and songwriter. He wrote Lift Every Voice and Sing. The group decided to form a new organization dedicated to protecting the rights of individuals and political groups. They chose the name American Civil Liberties Union. The ACLU is still around today and is still doing the work it was chartered to do 100 years ago. You heard a lot about their work last weekend in airports around the country. Chapters are organized in states and cities throughout the U.S., including Iowa. For a time, there was an active University of Iowa chapter, which met at Wild Bill's Coffee Shop. It's in that spirit that the founders who energized the ACLU and friends to oppose a new generation of efforts to block immigrants solely because of their views. This time, their religious views. We are lucky to have this organization and lucky to have the wisdom of those who started the organization a century ago. Thank you very much. Thanks for coming this evening. We'll see you again next Thursday. Good evening from Uptown Bills.